Hello, everyone. Oh, God, that's not the right screen. Hello, everyone. Oh, God, hello, everyone. My name is Pete. Welcome to Appearance. We're going to be playing some Roll for Shoes.
Roll for Shoes, yeah.
Yeah, this is a rules light RPG D&D thing. Sorry if you just heard myself me twice because of the echo or whatever. Thank you, Dan, for that host, and Pablo and Ben as well. Love you all. This is so before we start, we were going to just do Dungeon Runners today. That was originally the plan. Lindsay, however, is busy doing doctor things.
Lindsay wasn't
trying to get like a job.
And given how integral her character was to this part, it would have been kind of a dick move to either play her character for her with the possibility of her getting killed in her absence. Or having somebody else play her character, or just having her character run away in the presence of the dragon, which she totally wouldn't do. So we're doing something else.
She really wants to shoot the dragon.
Okay.
Really. And I don't endorse this.
The way Roll for Shoes works, it is a very simple game consisting of the 7 rules you see before you.
Yep, they're right there. That's all of them.
At any given time, you say what you do, and you roll a number of d6s. If the sum of your roll is higher than the opposing roll, the thing you wanted to happen happens. The number of d6s you roll is determined by the level of skill you have. At start of the game, you only have one skill, which is do anything, level 1. If you roll all 6s on your roll, you get a new skill at a higher level than the skill you used. However, the new skill must be a subset of the skill that you used in the roll. So, for example, if you were climbing a wall, your new skill could be athletics.
Right. And then you could use that athletics to do something else, like, I don't know, throw a ball really far. But then, if you got all 6s on that, then you'd have to choose another more specific thing to choose as a subset of that. So, ball throwing or object throwing, level 3.
Mm.
Which is now your skill.
And it gets more insane from there.
Yeah.
I will probably ask all of you to write on Roll20 just to keep track of your own skills, just because I'm not doing that shit for you. Either way, for every check that you fail, you get 1 XP. You may spend that 1 XP to change a die into a 6 for advancement purposes, helping you get more skills faster, but not for helping you succeed on the roll. Okay. That is pretty much the game.
Any yeah.
questions?
I mean, no. God. Okay. I'm a little scared. Okay.
Rat leaving scars.
Yeah, I have a question.
Yeah?
What about those characters?
Right. Yeah. So. This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Oh,
Stanley
no.
worked for a company at a big building.
Where no.
Number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427, and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee number 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy. All 4 of you are Stanley.
No!
Then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been in his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, He got up from his desk and stepped out of his office. What would you like to do?
I've played this game. Are we controlling the same person?
Yes.
No! Alright, I would like to split into a different person.
Alright, roll.
No, split into four. You should qualify that.
No, fuck you.
Ah!
I'm gonna stay as one person.
Hold on.
Osmosis?
Yeah, osmosis.
Oh god, you rolled a 13? How do you get to roll so many?
I'm the GM.
That doesn't make any sense.
You can't rig it.
It's only level 3.
Alright, well, there's no point in me rolling.
Because he only has 6.
No, but if you roll a 6, you'll
get you're right.
Yeah, roll anyway.
Okay. Oh god, okay, no. I did not succeed in splitting off into a new Stanley.
Well, you get 1 XP.
Woo!
Yay!
So we all start at 0, right?
You all start at 0 XP with the skill Do Anything 1.
And it's 1 XP to level up?
It is 1 XP to change a die into a 6 whenever you roll for advancement purposes to help you gain more skills.
Got it.
I'm confused. Okay.
Can I do something?
Yeah, go ahead. Like, you can do anything at any time
to deal with
this.
Darn it. Stanley did not strip.
Stanley did not strip.
But you get an XP.
Woo! Okay.
Does anyone else want to try and do anything as Stanley?
Can I try? Still just standing in the office. Like,
can I do quadruple osmosis again?
You can certainly try.
Okay.
All right.
Ah! Well, wait, no, this
is still roll.
So we don't all share skills, do we?
Hey, Akane. No, you are not first. Welcome.
I think this is rigged. He doesn't want us splitting.
You guys still haven't stepped out of the office.
Because we're trying to split.
I'll step out of the office.
All right. So you step out into the hallway. It's a fairly long hallway. You have an office that has four walls. It's its own room. But as you step out, you see more of an open floor plan office space. There's a printer, a few windows outside, and a few doors leading to other places in the building.
Okay, would I be able to... Oh, wait.
No, go ahead.
Okay. Would I be able to... just might look around, see if there's any memos left on the desks.
Roll to search for stuff on the desk.
Do it. Oh, God.
Hiding in plain sight. Okay. God damn it. Okay.
You see that there are a few papers on various people's desks, but they seem to be either blank or useless scribbles of sorts. Notes from when they were previously in the office, just days earlier.
So those notes are completely useless?
Yes.
Okay.
They are paper.
Would I be able to try and make sense of them? Is that what you mean? Or they're just not relevant at all?
You can certainly... You have found papers. You failed, but not completely. What you do with the papers is up to you. So
can
you
I can try and make sense of them?
Yes, you may. Okay.
So I can make a skill like travel, and that would that be like level 2? since I failed one of the rolls earlier, or like
make it like.
All right, so they seem to be like you're holding up two pages in your hand. One of them seems to be a recipe for chocolate chip cookies, and the other one apparently is an entire manual on quantum physics on a single sheet of paper.
Interesting. I attempt to
make chocolate chip cookies.
Using
quantum physics.
Okay. Roll for quantum cookies.
Quantum cookies. I'd eat them.
Whoops. I rolled a one. I also didn't type quantum cookies. Nope. All right.
Okay.
Is a tie a win or lose?
A tie, I'm going to say ties are in your favor.
Okay.
Okay.
We have not succeeded in doing anything yet.
Are we taking turns?
The papers.
Are we taking turns doing this, or we can just butt in whenever?
Stanley has decided to run down the hallway.
Okay. You break off into a sprint down the hallway. Give me a roll for not running into walls.
Doing it.
So being a competent human being needs a roll.
So you sprint down the hall towards God knows where in the office. You haven't specified. And turning a corner, you skid to try and like corner it faster, and you just slam your entire weight into a wall. Not much else happens. There is a small dent in roughly a humanoid shape, but the wall seems fairly intact, and fortunately so do you.
Then whereabouts are we now?
You are currently in a different section of the office on the same floor. From here, you know where the stairs to your boss's office and generally downstairs would be. However, the further away you go from where you
use... I have a question. I've played the Stanley Parable many times and know all of the endings.
This is okay.
I can't just do the things that you do in the Stanley Parable to get the good ending.
You could.
Can I try?
I was thinking of knocking on that one door a few times for that achievement.
Can Stanley try and fix the wall?
Roll to fix the wall.
There's nothing broken about the wall.
Yes, it's dented.
In a roughly humanoid shape.
Okay, fine. Roll masonry.
You said do anything.
Yep.
Ah, damn it. Okay.
Steve, stop! Steve's too good at rolling.
I mean, if you get... Oh!
So, you managed to find some of the chunks of wall that had fallen off, and you managed to fit them back perfectly in place. What is the new skill that you want to have?
So it has to do with wall masonry or masonry in
general. It has to do with fixing a wall somehow. It doesn't have to be wall masonry, but it has to
be... What about, like, repair?
Drywall talent. Can it be something with drywall?
Why do you want it? That's so specific. You can make it more general than that.
Okay, something general with walls?
Doesn't have to be walls.
With fixing things like walls.
Okay, with fixing things repair. Like walls. Repair. So I could just say repair, and that could apply to anything. Is that good?
It will apply to anything where you are making repairs.
Okay.
All right. I know what I want to do. I want to move Stanley into a closet.
Is this just so Stanley can come out of the closet again?
Can I make this a 6 and gain the skill travel? Is that how this works?
You don't need to.
So you walk into the nearest closet that you find.
I remember this.
You can make a 6 to gain the skill travel.
Awesome.
You now have travel level 2.
Well, how does he make it 6?
He used one of the XP that he had from failing.
Oh, okay.
I listened for the smooth, silky voice of the narrator.
Before we continue, do you all know how to draw and scribble and make notes in Roll20 on the screen itself?
Yeah.
Because if you guys want to jot down what XP you have and what skills you have, That would be a good thing to do.
How do you do that?
Are you literally the only one who doesn't know how to draw?
No, I'm the one who just drew that.
Oh. Okay.
Am I the only one that did it legitimately? My god.
Wait, do I have to write in roll 20? I have a good system going right now.
All right.
Roll a 6 for drawing.
You don't have to write
in roll 20. So we are now in a closet.
Keep track of it elsewhere. That is fine. I only suggested it so that the audience knows and can keep track of what skills you get.
Okay. Well, where do I write it? Okay.
Wherever the fuck you want.
Okay.
We're now in a closet for some reason.
Yep.
I'm going to attempt to break down the back wall of the closet.
All right.
I saw Steve roll the 5.
Against the wall, past like the shelf.
I'm using the experience point. I'm making that a 6.
Okay, you get a new skill from it, but you still don't break the wall. You slam your fist into the back of the wall, and it hurts a little bit. You shake the pain away. The wall is completely unfazed.
Okay.
All right.
So Stanley is wondering why he did this out of a sudden bit of rage. So he wants to call and probably schedule some sort of anger management.
Okay. Do you have? So do we have a phone on us?
I'm going find to an office phone? Admire the closet, by the way.
Roll to see if you have a phone. Roll for phone.
No, we're already admiring the closet.
Admiring this closet. This is a very nice closet. Although the shelves are neatly aligned, well organized.
Oh!
You reach into your pocket to the phone that you know is there, and you call from memory the phone number for anger management, and nobody picks up.
I'm gonna make a second skill of critique.
Can calling be just a skill I can make for that?
Yeah, you can have a skill for calling.
Okay. Since I rolled a 6, I'm going to make this a skill for art critique.
So nobody picked up and I got a busy signal. Is that it?
Yes.
Okay.
Mine is...
I didn't get any voicemail skill or anything.
You did not get to voicemail. It said, like, we're sorry, the number you have dialed is not available. Please try again later.
Can I try again later?
We're sorry.
Can I roll to try again later?
Sure.
Later, maybe.
Roll to call anger management again.
This is level 2 now.
All right. I'm going to roll to leave the closet. Or not to leave the office, rather.
Okay.
Not just the closet. Ooh. I figure that'd fall under travel, right?
Yeah, it would. All right. So you managed to make your way down the staircase and out the front door of the office, walking into an open street. Bustling city. You're currently standing about 10, 15 feet away from the road. However, there are absolutely no cars coming.
By the way, since I got a 6, do I get another level?
Only if both of them are 6. Oh. If you have an XP, you can make the 4 into a 6 and then level up.
Ah. I didn't fail that last art critique roll, which is what I was trying to do, so...
Wait.
Stanley is going to cheer because he left the office.
Is all that right. Right? Yeah. Go ahead.
Hell yeah.
All right, I'm going to go back into the office. Back to my desk.
Wait, so was the city was bustling? There were people around?
You walk out into what appears to be a bustling city, like, at the very least, sprawling and large, and very... There are obvious signs on the having been lived in and being a very productive city. However, there is absolutely nobody that you can see.
Okay, so that's different.
There are no lights on in the windows. All you hear is the sound of wind blowing between the buildings.
I'm going to try and pick up the building. Lift up the office.
Roll to pick up the building.
But it's not Arctreak.
I got a 4. Take that,
Steve. Level 20. All right. I'm gonna try and grab a lamppost and rip it out. That's Busta, right?
Sure.
Why? Is I
you with all your strength grab onto a telephone pole or a lamppost and try to wrench it from the ground after having tried to lift a building and in both cases,
seemed more reasonable.
In both cases you seem to not have gotten a sturdy grip on either of them.
Right.
The weight totally wouldn't have been a problem. It's just you couldn't grip it right.
Okay. Damn it.
Can I roll to go back into the building and make some cookies? Like, for real, not quantum cookies, but just real cookies?
You see a bakery across the street that is apparently, like everything else, abandoned.
Can I'm going to go back in the office.
Wait, no! Can I go to the office? Can I go to the bakery?
Both of you roll to go to various places.
Hey, I'm good at traveling, aren't I?
You are.
You can't turn that into a call, Ben.
No!
Can I call the bakeries to see if I can go to it? No, I'm kidding.
No.
Wait, no, that's wrong.
First roll to go to the bakery.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the bakery.
You got to beat my 4.
No!
Into the lobby area. The desk, like the receptionist, who normally you don't really pay attention to them because they're always there, they always let you in, but they're gone like everyone else. You see a phone off the hook just resting idly on the desk.
Loot everything, says Pablo.
Yep, just gonna rip the phone off the wall, put it in my pocket, like all the papers, I don't know why I want them, just put them in my pocket. No! You monster.
You open a drawer and find a few around a dollar in coins.
Heck yeah.
You feel special.
Dude, get some soda.
Okay. Can I bake cookies in the office kitchen?
You go to the office kitchen, you may roll to bake cookies.
Okay, good, because Stanley wants some cookies after finding this recipe. I swear, if you do some sort of leveled up crap. Come on, Stanley wants some cookies. Oh!
All right. So you managed to spend some time getting the materials. Surprisingly, this office is well enough stocked to have all of the supplies you need to make cookies. So after about 30, 45 minutes, which is like the usual time for preparing and baking cookies, you have like roughly 2 trays, about 2 dozen cookies.
Throw cookies out the window.
No,
I was going to do that!
No, don't do that.
We have to eat half a dozen cookies first.
We have to eat half a dozen cookies first, though.
All right.
Contest roll, my roll, Steve. Roll a 1.
The roll. Somebody, anyone.
I'll contest the roll. Okay. I'll contest the roll.
All right. No.
No cookies for you guys.
You did it.
The cookies out of a window because you're too busy eating them down. They are still very, very hot from having just come out of the oven, but you don't fucking care. They are delicious. What kind of cookies are they?
A chocolate chip? I thought they were for chocolate chip cookies. The recipe.
The recipe.
But no, the recipe said it was chocolate chip cookies.
The recipe did say it was chocolate chip cookie. I want you to roll for it anyway.
Okay. Logic!
Chocolatey chips.
Oh.
Oatmeal raisin.
Like, Anzac cookies.
Just barely. Right.
No, they are hey, oatmeal raisin is pretty good, okay? Yeah. I'm just gonna say that.
Eh. Unpopular opinion.
Yeah. So they're chocolate chip. They're pretty delicious. You feel good about yourself.
Alright, I'm gonna try and run really, really fast around the building and see how fast I can do it.
Okay, roll for speed.
Try and make a tornado.
Roll for speed?
No, just you know, I wanna set a record, you know? This is, I'd consider this travel, right? Alright, I'm gonna use one of my experience points to make a new skill.
Are we making Stanley Parables Flash?
That's what I'm working on. I want to travel back in time going so fast that I can go back to pushing buttons.
You can still push buttons.
You're still there. You can still push buttons.
Yeah, but it's not the same without the orders, you know?
So is he trying to get orders?
Yep.
Okay.
I attempt to give myself orders.
Roll for direction. Or leadership or something. The rest of you roll for following orders.
By the way, could I make the skill gain super speed a thing?
You could make the skill traveling quickly.
Okay, there we go.
No, that was the wrong one. I apologize.
Sure.
So we're
I'm
gonna
so
do.
Glad we have that.
All right. So wait, did we run outside and run around the building?
No, we're doing the orders, right?
You ran around the building. You haven't quite made it back around. You're kind of out of breath. You couldn't do a full lap. You're currently in one of the back alleyways. There's a
right.
A rat is sort of looking at you and eating a moldy bit of cheese. This is the only life you have seen other than yourself today.
I tackle the rat!
Can I try and roll for, what's the word?
No.
Pessimism. That's not the right
Pessimism?
Word.
Pessimism?
That's not the right word. Oh, what's that word? Like,
can I make
to
this
not
part
fight the rat?
No.
Pacifism.
Why? That's such
can
a simple
I make this,
word.
Like, can I make this a subset of straight up Busta?
Straight up Busta?
Yeah, that's my sure. skill that I got from trying to break down the door or to break down the wall.
Okay.
All right. I can live with that.
All right.
Wait, oh, never mind. Can I still roll to get the experience?
Anyway, to get experience, definitely. And to see if you level up.
Okay, I only did, like, I think I've only failed 2 rolls.
Ben just rolling. This is silly.
Oh!
Of course!
You level up pacifism, but you still...
Do I go to 3 now?
What? Nope.
No, you get a skill. You can level up to level 2 in something related to passive.
So I get no XP for that.
You get XP because you failed the roll.
Okay.
But you also get a skill because you rolled all 6s.
Can it just be pacifism, or does it have to be something more broadly than that?
It could be pacifism if you want it to be.
Yeah, pacifism.
Okay, you now have pacifism level 2.
I'm gonna try and cool. find a car to drive.
Hold on, wait, I just tackled a rat! What happened?
Right.
Sorry. After you tackled
What happened when I tackled the rat? No!
It's a good rat.
Where does the rat go?
Do I find a car?
It dives into the dumpster from one of the open, like, lid things into a pile of trash. You see a bit of movement and then nothing as all signs of the rat disappear in garbage.
I want to find a car to drive.
Okay. You want to find a car to drive.
I want to find a bus to drive. So we can't compete on every roll. Okay.
If you want to and you say it like within reason.
Oh, he already rolled. He already rolled. Okay.
Technically, then you can, but it serves no purpose.
But I want to drive a bus, not a car. I want to go big, go home.
Oh my god!
Can I drive my way to the space station?
The car door appears to be locked. You can't immediately find a way inside.
Can I find the key?
I'm gonna break.
Wait,
in.
No, you're gonna break in. Okay.
Yeah, and then just hotwire it.
Duh. Hold on, I'm the one who's good at busting.
Okay, I'll speedy bust and I'll
busting the window.
Instead of busting the window, I'm rolling to find a key. So can finding the key be some sort of subset of pacifism?
Yes, in this instance. If it is an alternative to violence, it is pacifism.
Okay.
Straight up bust us, Stanley! See, this is why. All right, so you find the key, but it break the window. Would break the window with it.
Stanley looks into the car window and sees the key to the car, like a comically oversized car key, just lying on the console between the front two seats. And the first thing that goes through his mind is, I need to get that key.
Bust it!
Breaks the window, sets off the car alarm, and grabs at the key. You now have an oversized car key to a car with a broken window in the driver's side.
Excellent.
I'm going to drive the car to a nearest space station.
Okay. Roll for navigation.
Yeah, actually, I wanted to make navigation actually my skill from finding a car to drive since I rolled
a
6.
Hey, hey, hey!
Yeah, sure.
All right. Damn! Oh.
Space!
The so final frontier.
You drive around a bit, you're sort of wandering around the ruined, not ruined, but abandoned, certainly, city. You're nearing the outskirts of town at this point. It's about mid-afternoon at this point.
Man, if only my my other self could use his phone to find us a space station.
I mean, we're in a populated city.
Oh, is this... No. Wait, what?
No.
use your phone skills to find us a space station.
Okay, can I call... Wait, well, no, that's just like phone calling, right? I can't use a GPS. Can I call the GPS?
Can I
call the space
phone
station?
Phone was skill.
Phone is skill.
Skill phone? Skill.
It depends on what skill you took, Ben. So if you took calling people on the phone, then you would not be able to call the GPS.
I call the space station and have them allow me to dock my car?
You may.
Dock your car. All right.
As you do with cars at space stations. I've been to Cape Canaveral, I know how this works.
So you pick up the phone, you're given a series of automated sort of menus, like pretty much any customer service automated call recipient thing. Mm-hmm. And you follow the menus as well as you can, and not only do you find the location of a nearby space station, but you somehow, over the phone, manage to access a parking pass.
Good.
Okay.
For the parking garage that they totally have.
Wait, so we get a parking pass?
Yes, to the space station.
So can I download it on my phone?
You have it downloaded.
Okay, good. Great. Okay, we're gonna go to that parking garage.
All right. Are we there yet, or are we on our way?
You're currently on the outskirts of town. You know where it is, but you have yet to go there.
All right.
Hold on. I'm gonna use my traveling quickly skill. That's at level 3 to get there as fast as humanly possible.
But I want to be drifting as well.
Sure.
Going on like mad, like Euro beats playing in the car. Can we do that? I haven't rolled anything for a while.
You can, Pablo, your role in this case, ignore the highway to hell. Your role would be to drive fast and safely, and speed. And Spivey, your role would be to start
like driving skill. Yeah.
Yeah. Drive in style.
All right.
Wee. Oh no.
So, Stanley, in the back of his mind, wants to do some sick stunts in this car, but as soon as he gets on the highway, he's like, "No, at these speeds, it would be hella dangerous. I need to play it safe."
All right.
Meaning he drives recklessly on the open road, completely empty highway. This is the only opportunity he has had to do something like this, but still safe enough to get there.
Yeah.
One good time, slightly over the speed limit.
Man, gonna make the traffic in generic city.
That's going to become a 6, and I'll make that a skill.
Okay.
Drifting?
Yeah, well, let's just make it drifting. Why not?
It could be stunts.
Okay. No, drifting it is.
So you manage to drive your way to the space station and make your way to the parking lot. The parking lot as well is empty, save for a few cars and otherwise no signs of people.
All right. Well, gonna go into the building.
Okay. You enter the building, and you see a very familiar sight. You look in the lobby of the space station, and over to your right, where you would expect the receptionist desk in your office to be, you see a receptionist desk.
Is there a receptionist?
There is not.
Kathy!
Can I call for a
phone on the desk that seems to have been sort of left there?
Can I page the receptionist?
You can call the receptionist.
Okay.
We're at the receptionist desk.
Yeah, but I want to talk to the receptionist.
But all right. Oh man.
Can I make that a 12?
You can, but that would only help you level up, not to
pass the roll.
Exceed the roll.
Well, I still.
So okay, you call the receptionist for the space station, and you hear the phone, which is currently off the hook and lying on the middle of the desk. You hear it.
That's good.
It doesn't appear like anyone's picking it up.
It'd be rude for somebody not to pick that up and answer since you're here, you know. You can.
Yeah. I answer the phone. With my other hand, I have a phone in each hand because we are all the same person.
Yes.
And I say hello.
Hey,
hello.
Man, how's it going? What are you up to?
What are you up to?
Oh, not much. I just answered the phone.
Not much. I just answered the phone.
You're currently talking to yourself.
Oh.
Can I call for split personality counseling?
No.
You can certainly try.
I'm gonna
get stopped.
I'm gonna make my way to a spaceship and try and board it.
But we gotta drift over there. We're going to be pretending to drift everywhere.
You know, I need to level that up. I'm going to use an XP to level that up.
Wait, hold on. Did you level up paging Kathy?
You would need to use 2 XP to level that up, because spending 1 XP changes one die from
Never mind. I should have done it with. I forego that. Okay.
All right. Okay. What did you say you were doing with drifting?
We're drifting to a space shuttle.
I want to find a spaceship.
We're going to a space shuttle. We're going.
So, roll to find a space shuttle and subsequently drift into the space shuttle.
I'll just do my navigation at level 2. Haha!
Alright. Oh god, where is this going? Hey, Dad, what's up, dude?
Am I rolling for drift?
Going to space. Yes, roll for drift.
Yes.
Was we're going to space for drifting?
Damn.
You're so bad at drifting.
My rolls are just impeccable everywhere. It's just...
All right.
So you find a shuttle past the facility in the door clearly marked employees only. You disregard that door entirely and choose and opt for the door to the left of it, which says employee bathroom. Anyone can use it, of course, because that's obviously how employee bathrooms work. You manage to go through the back, and somehow in the back of the bathroom, there's the door straight to the launch pad, and you find a rocket standing straight up, like soaring very tall into the sky. It is the tallest thing for miles at this point.
That is a weird toilet.
Can we use the bathroom because those cookies are not agreeing with me? I use too much baking soda, and it's just not working right down here.
To go to the bathroom.
Roll to pee. All right, this kid. Oh god.
Baking soda.
Ben, don't roll bad.
Oh, what is wrong with you?
Roll!
Yeah, I'm rolling!
So, looking up at the tall, erect face doll, you suddenly get the feeling that you need to go to the restroom, and those cookies certainly weren't agreeing to you. So you do a 180 into the employee bathroom and go to the restroom quickly before going back out onto the tarmac and admiring this engineering.
Chocolate wasted!
Right, we're gonna board the spaceship.
Hi, Mookie. You drift
onto the spaceship and you're not exactly in a thing that can drift. You as a person are not good at drifting.
You'd be surprised.
I would be very surprised.
You can drift infinitely in space, so that's the goal.
Wait, is it too late to make that into a skill?
You can make it a skill. Okay. You can make going to the restroom a skill.
Because I have to. It's too good. It's too good.
God. All right, I'm gonna travel very fast into space.
Okay.
With the spaceship.
All right.
Here we go. Why did I want us to go to space? I don't know.
You strap yourself in to the top of the rocket after having climbed the tower for quite a very long time, and you buckle yourself in, make sure you're all set, make sure the door is closed and sealed tightly so you are good to go to space.
Hang on, wait. We might need a crew, right?
And you realize you didn't start the countdown to launch the rocket.
Oh.
All right, I'm going to make a new skill since I have 3 experience.
So, I attempt to manually override that thing that you just said, the countdown timer.
Okay.
And I'm just gonna go for it. Pedal to the metal.
Okay.
And that's, you know, I'm straight up busting the rules.
Sure. We'll go with that.
I can't believe you're gonna allow him to do that.
Can I can I turn traveling quickly into traveling super fast?
You can have a level. You can level up your traveling fast to traveling extremely fast. Yes.
Yes. All right.
Not super fast. You are not inhuman just yet. But yes.
One more, I can make it super fast.
All right, all right. I'm gonna turn that into a six, so I can now have the ability to break rules.
Cool. I should not have given you this power.
Yeah, excellent.
Okay, what's the situation? What's the state of play?
You are currently strapped into the top of a, like, the nose of a space shuttle, preparing for flight. However, the countdown, you neglected to start it, and you are just slamming your foot against the floor of the capsule in an attempt to start the pedal that doesn't exist.
Can I stop what I'm doing and then do it properly?
Roll to do shit properly.
Hey, since that has something to do with the bathroom, can...
Yeah. Yeah,
can I do that? You're doing shit properly. Nope. All right, with my newly gained ability to break the rules...
Make yourself not follow the rules of humans.
Okay, so you...
All right, so... Oh, wait, sorry. Ben does his thing first. Carry on. We'll get to that later.
Can we...
I don't have to follow the rules, Steve. You gave me this power.
Can we nerf him?
Okay. What happens with Ben first? We'll handle this.
I made shit proper.
If it isn't a box like this, it isn't canon. But I don't need to follow the box rule.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. That's literally how everything works. So go roll for that.
Sorry, I don't have to follow your rules,
okay,
Steve.
Wait.
You
so
don't
I
control
made...
me.
Speedy, stop your power trip. I need to know if I made shit proper.
Okay, yeah.
You manage to exit the shuttle, go down to mission control, and start the launch timer. All of the stuff that normally takes a crew of 20, a few minutes, good minutes to do, you manage to do in about 40. It's surprisingly easy. They had, like, macros and shit already automated, checklists for you to go through. Everything's pretty done and proper.
What's
However,
the timer?
You're standing in mission control now, and you're looking at the countdown timer, and it starts ticking down 5 minutes.
Hey, travel to the rocket really quickly and abort it.
Yeah.
I do so.
All right. This is a go fast time. Here we go. Oh boy. Oh boy.
Literally Metal Harbor from Sonic Adventure 2.
All right, so you dash out of the way, out of the room, bolt onto the tarmac, and sprint as fast as you can up the, like, 20 flights of stairs before you hear this.
Can I roll to assist by breaking the laws of physics to run faster than the speed of light to catch up to that spaceship? Well, maybe not that fast. Because,
roll to break physics.
Roll to break physics. Okay. All right, this is level 3 now.
Come on, wait,
who wants to sit in the Stanley Parable office and we can
I didn't make it.
It's not a jet plane, it's a spaceship.
Leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. It's an Armageddon reference.
To the top, and the shuttle is starting to lift off, and the tower that you're currently now at the top of is precariously starting to
wait
from the shuttle and like fall away from it.
Can I propel myself with gas, like flatulence, to try and catch up with it?
Oh my god.
This would use the restroom skill.
Yes.
Amazing. Oh god. What have we done?
Can I attempt also after this?
No!
To run so fast that I can run up the currently climbing spaceship and then get into the door.
How about
like, run straight up the wall?
To gain speed.
Yeah.
Right?
Gain speed, you say?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, climbing quickly into the, you know, the open door.
No.
Is that a thing I can do?
How can you start at level 5, though?
No!
you leap out over the precipice towards the rocket and attempts to run up the ways to the capsule as it is, the rocket is, you hear the fire at the bottom and you start running up, but your feet can't quite grip onto the metal, so the best you can do is flail and grab onto a railing that for some reason is on the outside of the rocket. You are holding on for dear life, and the rocket begins to take off.
Okay, can we... Okay, how about we abandon the rocket and go back to the office?
No!
Ben
is having doubts. The Ben part of Stanley is having doubts, but the rest of us are not.
Okay, I said what I said. Can I do that?
You can attempt to let go, I guess.
You can attempt to travel back to the office.
Yes, that's what I'm going to do.
Use the rocket to travel back to the office. All right.
No! can I level up that?
You may.
Okay.
That's stop doing something, level 2.
Wait.
Oh god, should not give Ben that power. It's going to stop us from everything we do.
Dude, I'm working on teleportation. Can I make my next skill teleportation?
That can be my next skill too.
It's you would have to actually teleport in order to get teleportation, I would say, because that's a pretty broken power.
Darn, I'm at level 4.
Anyway, the rocket at this point is starting to gain some speed and altitude.
Oh boy.
You're clinging outside. It's about 50 feet of climbing against gravity and the thrust of the rocket to make it into the capsule. After which you have to open the capsule door, get inside, and strap yourself in with all of the turbulence that that's going to imply.
Easy, I'll do it right now. Okay,
here we go. Just do it. Just do it. So easy. Just don't mess it up.
Here we go. Easy.
Hey!
Hey!
No way!
So... in a feat of superhuman speed, you
Aurora can do it.
Superhuman
bolt up
speed.
The ladder, not even like pausing to. You let go of the previous run before even grabbing onto the next one. You're so fast. You like pull open the. You pull open the door, the hatch to the shuttle, and climb your way in, and. you notice that you ripped the thing clean off.
Oh no.
Wow. Superhuman strength and superhuman speed.
All right.
I mean,
hold my breath.
Drift.
Here, I'm gonna navigate the rocket into the ocean.
Okay.
Are you gonna drift?
I thought we were going to space.
Well, not with an open door.
What you were just doing.
Hold on, I'm gonna navigate the rocket. Hold on, are there any parachutes in this place?
Roll to find parachutes.
I thought I had a skill for doing something else. Would that fall under navigation?
Bye, Dad. See ya. Thanks for coming out.
It would not.
Pair of chutes.
What's he rolling for?
Well,
you
doesn't have... matter. But
are you good at finding?
Get the experience.
No, you're not. No. That's bad.
You do not find any parachutes in the capsule that you're currently in. It is a very bare and small capsule, maybe fit for one or two people.
Okay.
Thrust into space.
So, what's the state of play? We're getting thrust into space.
You are currently gaining altitude fairly quickly. You are safe relatively from the turbulence and the sheer wind because you are inside the capsule. However, the door is near broken and dangling on the rocket.
I want to repair the door.
Hey, it comes in handy.
Roll to repair the door.
Oh, yeah.
Ben the Fixer. Now, the door itself most likely fell off into the abyss, so this will be very impressive if you can do this. Also, that should have only been level 2, I think.
No, I did it twice.
Well...
But you didn't
you
get
have to
a...
use experience points.
No, you didn't... When you level up, you have to level up in the skill that you just used, so... You never repaired anything past that, so you would still be level 2 regardless of what you leveled up.
Wait, so if I were to use... Okay, never mind. I don't know what I did then. I thought I failed a repair roll earlier, and then I...
Alright, that's fine. I'm going to...
Oh, and I forgot to do that.
Thank you, Steve.
I'm going to take a hold of the controls of the spaceship... And I'm gonna put the pedal to the metal, gonna try and break the laws of physics, and travel faster than the speed of light in the spaceship, because that makes sense, and it should be easier than doing it not in a spaceship for sure.
Okay, Pablo, you roll against that to navigate it into the ocean.
Oh, sure.
Alright.
I actually will do this.
This is level 3 for me.
Under the sea.
No.
Under the sea.
That's not the one that won, though. So,
down where it's wetter.
Oh, and I'm gonna use 2 experience to level up in to
do you?
No, just in breaking the laws of physics.
So, where previously there was no pedal, you managed to find a pedal and subsequently slam it to the metal, thrusting the rocket faster than physically possible, into space. You are going so fast that the vacuum of space cannot keep up with the air that is in the capsule.
But you really want to drift.
Somehow you can breathe. And
you really want to be the fastest drifter.
You are now in space.
You are now the fastest
drifter. Can I roll to travel fast enough to go back in time?
Yeah, that's what I just did. I was trying to go trying to travel through time.
Can I roll to try and turn this into an R-Wing and then go
I have
to corner area?
Travel extremely quickly.
Ah, never mind. I can't beat that. I can't beat that.
Very fast doggo. Incredible high speed. Oh, God, Ben.
Hey. Come on. It had to have happened at least Drift once. In space.
Oh my god.
What? You could level that up.
I'm going to, absolutely.
I'm already breaking the laws of physics. That's fine, whatever. I can break other laws of physics.
All right. So, you start to look outside the door of the capsule, and you see stars passing you by, becoming long, thin streaks of light as you travel faster and faster and slower and backwards.
And sideways.
Where in time are you traveling to?
The second day of my job. And then we're gonna go back to the ocean. Back to the office. And we're gonna go push those buttons.
Wait, no. Because, wait, the first day of your job?
The second day.
Why not the first day?
So,
I mean,
day two of the job was when this happened.
You travel back in time to...
No, he did it for more than
very,
that.
Very clearly, the second day of your job.
Yes.
Not the first day of the job, but the second. You missed your first day of work. So this is technically the first day you actually worked. However, you were still in a spaceship that is still traveling through space.
Okay, I'm going to navigate to the ocean.
Oh my god.
Wait, can I just abort, you know, like being in the space at all, like being in the spaceship at all, and just go back to the office?
You can try.
Please, it's gonna be level 3, aren't you? That's what you're rolling, aren't you? I can't fix that, though.
Dude,
That one guy from Hole's voice, I can fix that.
Okay, I'm leveling. I'm gonna level that up.
Okay. You are leveling up a boarding.
Okay, I'm gonna make it a boarding everything. Or boarding some things.
What? What did you just try aborting?
Aborting actually being in space. Aborting.
You could have a skill in revert to last save.
Okay, revert to last save. So that replaces aborting.
So time travel also. We have 3 time travelers and a drifter.
So that reports. I mean that replaces aborting.
No, you still have aborting as a level 2 skill, but you now have revert to last save as a level 3 skill in addition.
By the way, with that 3-6 roll, I wanted to level up my travel extremely quickly to super speed. Does that work? Yes.
What? It's just so fast. So fast.
Too fast.
The very fast doggo run incredible high speed.
Incredible high speed. Are you a very fast doggo?
Carry on.
Speedy? So you are still drifting through space, and you actually can't hear anything because of the vacuum of space. No sound.
Drifting through space, you say.
You're traveling faster than light, faster than sound. You try to yell, but you can't hear your own voice.
Okay.
It is disconcerting.
So I'm very terrified.
I want to get to the ocean.
I'm very terrified. Wait, okay. Wait, what are we doing? Did Palma take precedence? Because
You try to get to the ocean.
I rolled a 4 earlier.
But you're in space.
Oh.
Oh, that's all. Alright, are we okay on breathing?
For now.
Break the laws of human nature so that we don't have to breathe. Thanks.
Alright, I'm going to attempt to, break the laws of physics to just travel faster than the spaceship would normally be able to travel to go to whatever planet is nearby, I suppose. Nearest planet I see.
Okay.
How to breath.
That's what he said. How to breath.
Oh yeah. No we.
Can I Can I roll to try and make the game master use correct grammar?
No.
No, can I, Steven?
I want to say no as well.
You technically have a do anything skill at level
Glenn
1.
Ho.
Yeah, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. So
I'm attempting to make the ship break the laws of physics, go land on a planet and do so safely despite the fact that there is literally nothing stopping it from crashing.
Okay. So
hey, making my own rules is my thing.
Mm-hmm. Wait, go make the rules. Go make the rules, Speedy.
What? 180 no scope? Oh.
So, you managed to turn the ship around, ignoring physics in that regard and how thrust would normally work. Spivey, you would be impressed by how well he just drifted. But
I'm also upset. It's
okay. You are now rocketing back pinpoint accuracy directly at the Earth.
Okay, can I try?
That was the planet we were nearest to still? Cool. Yeah.
Okay, can I try and revert? Can I just try and revert and go back to the office?
You can try and revert and go back to the office.
Dude, once we land, I'll just super speed us run across the ocean and then we can get to the office quickly, you know? Run on water, easy.
Determination.
No!
Oh.
Okay, I'm going to level that up.
Careful with the yelling, Ben.
Wait, no, you can't level loud.
That up. You would have to spend 3 XP to level that up.
Oh, actually, yeah. Okay, never mind.
Wow, right.
Wait, so there's no way I can, like, see my audio levels and, like, take them down?
So, I mean, maybe, you are now a very fast shuttle traveling at incredible high speed.
Yes.
Back toward the planet Earth.
Ocean!
Roll to hit the ocean.
No, ocean, geez. Ocean near where we left off.
Why did you want to go to space and just then turn us right back? Ocean man,
well, if we had a door,
take me by the hand, take me to the land.
I'd be more excited about traveling through space, but we don't have a door.
So, the Earth slowly becomes less than a blue speck and increases in size as you approach it at incredible high speed. And you notice that the nose of the shuttle is pointed directly in the center of the continent of Asia.
There's not a lot of water in Asia, guys.
Okay, can we brace to not die?
Drift it. You drift it to live.
That makes drift sense.
Oh, whoops. What have I
just rolled a drift.
Oh, I just ruined the page. I'm getting a
space boy. Drift, okay.
That's not good for you.
What's your level on drifting? Is it 2?
Level 3.
It's only 2 because I haven't rolled anything.
Yeah, it's true.
So, it's going to be rough.
Come on. Wait, no, he can't do it. Never mind. So, are you always rolling a level above us?
I'm not trying to.
But no, wait, you're not trying to roll a level above our skills?
He's rolling on how difficult he thinks it should be to manage.
I'll level that up to 3.
Okay.
Will that help?
So what subset of drifting are you now proficient in?
Aerial life saving.
Aerial drifting. Excellent. Yeah.
Drifting in life or death situations. Drifting away from danger.
So you yank on the... Is there a steering wheel in space shuttles? Apparently so. You
this
yank the steering wheel to turn the nose away. And you manage to slide the nose slightly in the direction of the Mediterranean Ocean. The Mediterranean Sea, my bad. The nose is just barely pointing at one of the coastlines on the edge of the sea. You're not sure if it's still on land or water yet. and you are approaching very, very, very.
Oh, by the way, I'm gonna activate the parachutes.
What parachutes? You didn't find any parachutes.
No, there's parachutes on spaceships.
Not this one. You didn't find any.
No. Like no, to slow them down in their landing.
Is this Kerbal Space Program?
Roll for a completely different game, Speedy. This would use your breaking the game skill.
Pablo just rolled for that.
You roll against him.
But I'm trying to do the same thing.
Okay, fine. You.
But I'm gonna roll.
No, he can't. It's too late.
Do I just find the shoot button to activate the slow down mechanism of spaceships that they normally have?
Game changer. All right.
Welcome to Kerbal Space Program.
Are we still Stanley?
You are still Stanley.
Okay.
In Kerbal Space Program?
Do we still have that wonderful British narrator?
So, Steve is your narrator.
Hello.
Steve now has to speak like a Kerbal, right?
Wow. Okay.
That's going to be hard to understand.
I've never played this game.
That sounds about right. I don't think they use real words, though.
All right.
That's going to make it very hard to understand his DM. So I use my powers of game breaking. I'm actually going to I'm gonna use 2xp to level that up as well. So I'm now proficient instead at changing the game.
Instead of blanket saying we're now in Kerbal Space Program, you were the one who changed the game. What game do you want it to be?
Oh man, I can choose any game?
Hey, make it our D&D session from last week.
I could make... Suddenly, Lindsay's Stanley... here.
No, suddenly Stanley just appears in the middle of our sessions.
I could make it FTL, but then we're only in space still. And then we're fighting aliens. No.
Make it like Need for Speed.
Oh god, what's a good game?
The Beginner's Guide.
Made by the same authors, let me tell you.
Make it the Beginner's Guide.
No. Langoscoff and the Terribly Cursed Tiger.
I'm going to make it...
Three buttons.
What's under your blanket?
No!
That's too hot for Twitch.
We're in a spaceship right now. I can only do so much. We've got a spaceship. I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna crash that spaceship right into
No!
Shower with your dad simulator.
That's a game on
I'm gonna crash that spaceship right into I'm looking at my Steam library. Genital jousting. No.
No. Oh, no. That's even worse.
Factorio is a game.
Factorio is a game. That's not the one we crashed into, though. We're crashing into Hotable Boyfriend.
Oh.
No!
All right. Okay. I'm gonna need a second to find.
I'm so happy. All right. We have left the Stanley Parable and entered the Pigeon Dating Simulator.
Man, we gotta apply for a job now. Instead of just going back to our office.
Wait, are we automatically turned into a bird?
Did you just put on Hot to Pull Boyfriend music? This is Hot to Pull Boyfriend music, isn't
it? Hey, you know, maybe we traveled back in time to the past, but maybe Hot to Pull Boyfriend was already the world we were in, you know? And we just travel back in time.
You steer the rocket not away from the point you're at, but rather through the point. And when you think you would crash into the world, the middle of the Mediterranean Ocean, like near the shore, instead you approach at very high speed, and as soon as you breach the water, everything goes dark. You wake up, and there's a bird sitting on your face in bed next to you.
Sitting on my face? Oh man, I don't remember consenting to this.
Can we roll for kids?
Wait, no.
Roll for eggs.
Can I roll to... Wait, oh wait, never mind.
Are you all hearing this music? Because I'm not...
No, I can't hear it. I can hear it. Because I'm not even...
It's kind of quiet, but I can hear it.
Yeah, so can I roll for kids?
Roll for kids.
Oh, hell yeah. Oh no. That's right. Bird. Free XP. I'm stacking it up.
The bird hops off of your head to the headboard behind you and off to a safe distance of a few feet away. And it chirps at you, and somehow you can understand exactly what it is trying to say. And it is sad and disappointed in you for missing your first day of school. It is evening on Monday, and you are in a very, very feminine looking bedroom, which is odd because you, as Stanley, know that you are very much a guy.
However, I mean, we never
you checked. Also know somehow that this is your room.
You all look right.
Around and look back, and the bird is no longer there.
Can I revert to last save?
You can try. Speedy roll game
because this is a little too, you know, it's a little too weird for me. I don't like it.
Speedy, you don't want to date a bird? Again. Okay.
Speedy loves dating birds.
That's true. That's a great
100%
game.
100%
the game. Because, I don't know. It's really weird. Okay. I'm waiting for Speedy to roll first to see if I can.
This is level 4?
Yeah.
I think 4. All right. No!
You decide fuck it and go back to sleep, and in your dream you feel the sensation almost as if you're swimming and floating, and you wake up with a salty taste in your mouth and see wreckage of a spaceship next to you. You are floating in the middle of the Mediterranean Ocean. You see land off in the distance, but you're not sure how far away it is.
All right, I'm going to use my super speed to run on the water and get us back to the office.
Okay. Roll to run on water.
Hey, you better make the contesting roll not so speedy, or I will be sad. My level 5! Woo!
You run quickly. Well, first off, you stand upright and start treading water, and then instinctively you start making a running motion, which is slowed by being in water, but somehow you notice that you are moving faster and faster and moving in a straight direction towards land, and before you know it, you are running on the surface of the water, and it is an incredible feat. You are making it to the nearest landmass. However, you don't know if your office is on said landmass.
Can I look to see if this is like North America where my office is? I think I could tell pretty easily.
You could wait till we're there.
Well, are we there?
You're currently running on the ocean. You get to the shoreline and skid to a stop on the sand. If you want to roll to drift, you can roll to drift on the water.
Come on, Spivey.
You've got drifting and aerial drifting now. This is water drifting.
Oh, so do I just roll level 2 or level 3?
Just roll level 2.
Oh.
Oh.
All
right. You attempt to sort of drift on the water and make waves, and you end up crashing into the waves and rolling the rest of the like 50 feet or so. You were going really fast and washing up like, on shore.
It's like skipping rocks.
Yes. Several bones are broken. You're not in a good way. You haven't bled at all this entire encounter.
Can I roll to repair myself?
You may.
You could revert to last save.
But why do that?
Why do that? Okay, but should I?
Yes.
Okay, I want to revert.
You can pull like a tracer from Overwatch.
You should repair yourself.
I get that feeling of deja vu.
Okay.
The world needs more heroes.
Doctors are just people repairmen, right? They're just like contractors for flesh.
You ever get that feeling of deja vu?
Game changer surgeon simulator.
Come on, Ben, get that deja vu. You need it exactly 12. With your
No! Award.
Do you have XP?
Yeah, I'll make it more. I'll just have to do one, right? Okay. So, what should I do it? What should be it?
Alright, you know? I'm gonna roll the die faster.
Wait, no. Wait. I wanna... What would be the next up from just general repairs? Would I have to go, like, more... specific?
It would have to be a subset of repairing things.
Okay, repairs.
So it could be like medical repairs.
Medicine.
Yes, that's
it,
very
good.
It would
have to involve repairs somehow.
Repair people.
Surgery.
Surgery. Haircuts. Sure.
I will give you surgery. Not actually, but you have the skill surgery now.
Andy, yes, that's how that works.
That's
rolling the die faster makes you die faster.
Okay. So, do you want to die faster?
Yep. You know, since we're already doing the Overwatch thing, might as well.
Oops. that is level 1. My bad. Let me just redo that.
Are you sure?
Yes!
No! Wins. Okay, is that it? Are we done?
So you lie back on the sand, your entire body just aches all over, and with...
I changed the game.
I referred
to... Wait.
A very...
Okay, yeah, it's 5e.
With a very determined look in your eye of sadness and longing for times gone.
Spivey. I'm sorry. That was really good.
Alright, yeah, that's a subset of aerial drifting.
I spent 2 XP to level that up.
You close your eyes and embrace the swiftly enveloping blackness.
Right. Level 4 will be Drift God.
Can I revert to last save?
Or Angel of Drift.
You can try, yes.
I want to revert to the office before I made cookies. Well, after I made cookies.
That's not the last save.
What was the last save?
The last save would be you drifting in the middle of the ocean, because that was the last save you
Okay, were. I guess we're drifting. Okay, that's we're drifting in the middle of the ocean.
Beyond.
Okay.
So roll.
For the save or the drift?
For the save.
I'm trying to think of something witty to put in here.
What's a game about hell?
There's a bullet hell in Enter the Gungeon.
Dante's Inferno.
Oh, that one.
Okay, we're.
How is that game? I've never played it. Would that work?
It's like a God of War. Is that what it's called?
Okay, yeah. So you revert back to the save where you were just waking up from crashing in the ocean.
Okay.
Okay.
The burning wreckage again.
Trying to drown myself.
No!
Oh, why do you keep doing this?
Can we vote Pablo off the island?
Oh, we're all inside the same person.
Drowning.
I'm gonna make this as part of my travel quickly, actually, to swim as far down into the ocean as possible.
You could have made right. level 4.
Okay, so now that that's happened, can I revert to the last save again?
Yes.
No, wait. Hold on.
No,
hold on.
We're dying.
No!
We're dead. Echo the Dolphin! Yes!
Ben, please be quiet.
I'm sorry. Excuse me.
It's a bit loud. It's okay.
I'm excited. How dare you?
All right, changing game to Echo the Dolphin. Yeah!
So, you descend into the deep and release all of your breath, and just as you're about to fade into darkness, you see something swimming up from the shadows to meet you. Its silver fin pushes against you and drags you back up to the surface. You breach the water in a majestic display, and you are riding Echo the Dolphin up into the sun.
Amazing!
I would like...
Glorious! Spam is...
Alright,
just drifted on a dolphin!
Yeah.
You leveled up in drowning, Pablo. You can do that at level 2.
Yeah, you can.
Oh, I can! Ha ha!
Can I try and
just wait.
Vote off this, like, oh wait, never mind.
No, wait for Pavel to roll first.
But he did roll, he rolled a 4.
He can roll level 2 because he leveled up when he drowned.
It doesn't matter, he's not going to succeed anyways.
How about I just go try and swim at super speed to the bottom of the ocean? since I can...
That was very different from what you attempted to do, so I'm going to say no.
Okay. drown level 2. Let's go, boys.
Okay, so you are now riding back as a dolphin off into the sunset majestically, yes?
And we are drifting Echo Dolphin. Echo
drifting
on Echo the
dolphin.
Dolphin.
Into the sunset majestically.
Can we drift him into Valhalla, or is that...
That's what I'm trying to do, Spivey.
We're past that already, we're not dead.
I'm working on it.
We're gonna try and... I think we should try and drift onto land.
Okay.
I'm gonna use physics breaking to try and make this dolphin be able to swim on land.
You may.
Yes.
While he's doing that, can I roll to purge of all suicidal thoughts and actions?
You can use your pacifism skill.
Yes.
Ooh. All right, I'm gonna roll against this, and if I fail, then I will stop trying to kill a character.
Yeah. If Jesus can walk on water, Stanley can swim on land. Step back from that ledge, my friend. Oh, won't you step back from that ledge, my friend?
Alright, I'll stop trying to kill the character.
You drift directly onto the shoreline, and a wave of sand billows forth as you are still swimming through the beach on Echo the Dolphin.
Alright, we're riding into town. We're gonna look around and see where we are. Where the fuck are we?
You ride off in some direction you're not familiar with this area, so you don't really know where town is. But you do find you do find eventually a small, what appears to be a village, a few huts, but unfortunately, very similar to what you remember from the office, there is absolutely nobody here.
Can I use my super speed to run around the world a few times to try and find something familiar?
Sure.
That's very fast. We're just literally just like the Flash, and we're breaking like every rule.
Is this the way you envision this happening, Steve?
Kind of, not really.
Hey, we did it! We did the same thing!
Oh my god, you people.
We had the same idea.
I'm gonna let you level up a skill just for that.
Alright. So you ran around the world? Oh no, he's failed and run it.
You failed to run around the world. You run as fast as you can towards the ocean, and you make it to another continent by the time the 80 seconds passes, and you are very, very much out of breath.
Do we recognize this continent?
Can I level up my travel at super speed to travel instantaneously?
No, because you didn't.
What do you say? Why can't you do it? Steve, why can't you do it? It's completely valid.
Because it was not something that he did that time.
Ah, okay.
You have to do something before you can get a skill in it.
Yeah.
Oh, well, oh, I thought that's what you were saying. I could level up something because we had the same title.
You can level it up, but the thing you just tried to do was run around the world in 80 seconds, and that was not you were not attempting to travel instantaneously.
No, I was trying to... Oh. Okay.
So unfortunately, that's not how that works.
I was hoping to progress from traveling to traveling quickly, super speed, but whatever. I gotcha.
So what are you gonna level it up into?
Drowning number 3.
No, that's not. That's also not what you just tried to
I
do.
Know,
it has
I
to. Yeah.
Well, I don't have any. I mean, what am I supposed to do after super speed, right?
Well, what does the Echo think?
Run.
Does he have an opinion?
Run across oceans, maybe.
Oh, maybe I'll just like run with
across oceans.
Also, wait. Stamina. Were we running or are we riding Echo still?
I was running.
Can we try and understand what Echo's?
Echo behind.
No,
Echo's gone.
Echo back. Can we
Echo's
get Echo
another...
back?
No.
Can we get Echo back.
Revert
can we
to last save.
Echo.
Revert to last save. I want Echo.
Echo location.
But I have to try and drown myself again, but you purged all the suicidal thoughts.
Oh so. My god, this is 5e echo location.
Can I...
Glad someone got that.
Echo
location. There's a lot of good puns coming out of this.
It is like 10 o'clock, wow.
It's we've barely begun. Is there a win condition for this, Steve?
No.
There really should be.
My win condition is getting back to the office on back in time so I can push buttons again.
Alright.
I miss Echo.
So you fail at doing that. We're over on this other continent. Do we recognize this continent?
You're back on North America. Your office was roughly in the
in West Philadelphia.
The Boston,
born and raised.
Cambridge, probably.
Cambridge? Did we work at MIT? Where's the space station near there?
It is not. You had to drive quite a ways to get to the space station.
Okay. Fair enough. Let's go back to the office.
Okay.
Just walk there. At a regular speed.
Walk at a reasonable pace. Back to
for
the office.
For several days.
Back to the office.
You get there and... The city remains unchanged.
I thought we were in the past.
You were in the past. The city is slightly changed. Some of the buildings that you see on the skyline are no longer there as they were when you first started this job. There was some construction going on more downtown.
But you walk towards the office along the empty streets, and you do seem to have gone back in time, and yet there is still absolutely nobody around.
I mean, that's fine, as long as there's still orders barking in the office, right? Let's go back to the office and see, since you don't know what orders barking on that day.
Okay, so is it still unpopulated everywhere?
It would seem so.
Can I try and populate the Earth myself?
Get Echo to help you. I mean, technically, yes. Animals are still around, apparently.
No!
Nope.
Oh, we were doing osmosis. I mean, like, just...
All right.
People! Let there be people. But,
hold on, okay. I'm actually going to try and do the same thing. Via my breaking the rules, I can't do breaking the rules of physics or the game, but I can break the laws of nature. And that's what level, that's level 3 then. Asexual reproduction. Let's go. No.
You will yourself have a child of your own flesh and blood, and nothing happens.
Can
but
I,
Stanley? You're still very
get pregnant. Get pregnant,
can
but
I...
it doesn't work out. It doesn't take.
Ooh. Can I level up my osmosis
You're
and make
man.
It osmosis? Can I level up my osmosis and make it osmosis?
You can make it like self osmosis.
You can level up in asexual reproduction if you so wish.
Okay, good.
Nevertheless, you have tried and failed to make people in this unpopulated, currently unpopulated, abandoned city that you used to work in, that you still technically work in. It's like you're third, fifth day, depending on travel time it took to get here from Echo. Walking back to the office, the streets are still quiet. What do you do?
Can I attempt to commune with the Drift Kings of Valhalla?
You
Please.
May attempt to commune with the Drift Kings of Valhalla.
Does that count as drifting?
It does not count as drifting.
To do so, I have to be drifting in a perfect circle.
That's how you. That's how you contact the Drift Gods.
That's how it works.
All right. Describe how you are communicating with the Drift Gods of Valhalla.
All right. So you're doing doughies, right? You're drifting in a circle, but there's a hose from the exhaust into the car, so it like smokes up as you're doing drifts, and all the windows are wound up, and it's almost like meditating.
So it's almost like dying of carbon monoxide poisoning.
So basically,
well, yeah.
You're hotboxing yourself in a car that you're doing donuts in.
You're
hotboxing with carbon monoxide.
Yes. Into yourself. Yes.
Hey, Dan.
Let the flames of your passion consume you. You quickly break into a car. I'm not going to have to have you do those rolls again unless you really want to.
I really want to.
Busting makes you feel good.
You start driving around in circles. Roll with drifting to communicate to the Drift Gods of Valhalla.
Can I roll to not...
Level 4, yeah?
No, level 2. Well,
level 4.
Actually...
I drifted into Valhalla.
Air drifting?
And
oh,
wait. Level 4.
Can I roll not to die from carbon monoxide poisoning?
You didn't succeed
in
drifting to Valhalla, did you?
You didn't succeed in that, and also...
No, but I spent my XP to level it up.
It would have had to be a subset of drifting on... It would have to have been a subset of aerial drifting.
Right.
Which was only level 3.
Maybe I need to drift off a cliff.
Yeah, drift off a cliff.
Okay.
There are no cliffs in Boston.
Fill the car with its own exhaust smoke, and then drive through the wooded Boston terrain without being able to see anything. Goal to not crash into a tree.
Man, you guys were yelling at me for trying to kill the character.
Does anyone else have,
I guess what he's doing with style.
Sort of thing? Or what are we rolling for that?
Can I use pacifism to not drive into a tree?
Don't want to hurt nature. There we go.
Yeah, don't want to hurt nature.
I guess that's a kind of pacifism.
Yes, I'm going to do that.
Welcome back, Dad. Also, Ben and Mukia, thank you for that Twitter love.
You're welcome.
Bless. What's happening? Trees, man, trees. Our trees. You're hotboxing.
Okay, so that's level 2. Damn it.
Tree hugging Gloria Alred?
Not crash into trees.
Oh.
I mean, I have navigation, but I'll just put it, you know, whatever.
Spivey.
Level 2 navigation.
Drift around it.
Okay.
Oh, no.
That's only level 2.
Yeah, that's only level 2. And I left the same text because I just wanted to roll.
Hey.
Oh, right, shit.
So, drift around every single tree. And in the woods, you spell out with your skid marks tearing up dirt, you spell out the word Valhalla. And then start doing donuts around a small cluster of trees, which then sink into the ground as a portal to another dimension opens up, and you hear music of the gods welcoming you to the glorious, glorious halls of Valhalla.
I'm gonna travel back to the office.
No.
Can we go? Can we all go to
we're
the...
going back to the office.
Can no!
Will this be a travel quickly?
Can I roll to abort? To abort
you
traveling
may.
From the office?
You can abort traveling. Attempt to. Both of you roll against each other.
Wait, can I revert to my last save then? Wait, it still won't work. So how are we going to get out of this?
You get out of the car.
Wait, how are we going to get out of this?
You pull the car over next to the churning portal with like its orange glow emanating out from it. Step out of the car, look at it, and just fashion
wait.
Way I've never run before.
Wait, right now.
Steve, did you roll?
He was rolling against
Ben.
Well, Ben,
okay, I think he should still have to roll just in general because he's trying to run to another dimension?
No, he's running back to the office.
Okay, can I revert
right, which
Ben?
Is in another dimension now because
no,
we're in Valhalla.
We didn't go through the portal. Yeah,
can I revert Ben? Can I revert now? Since he's running, I'm going to revert now.
He'll be against the traveling extremely quickly.
Well, can I revert so it doesn't go against his 21?
Roll anyway.
Roll anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Can I level that up?
Futility?
You would have to spend 3 XP, which you definitely have.
I'm going to level that up to revert to any save.
Sure.
Oh, God. Ben is going to start us all over again.
Okay, so are we back at the office?
You are back at the office.
Now I would like to revert to the save in
Ben.
Valhalla.
Ben,
I would
quiet,
like to reserve
quiet.
To... Okay.
Let me just it's have okay. a day of button pushing before we go to Valhalla.
You walk into the office and you look over to the receptionist who, this is your like first week of work. You haven't actually shown up to the office at all this time around. So you're hoping to not get fired by your boss for not showing up literally the entire week. But you notice the receptionist isn't there. There's a phone on the desk, off the top, just laying down, slowly having a dial tone go endlessly. Just
there's all right, go back to my room.
Hmm?
Go back to the room and seeing if I get some orders to push buttons.
Okay. You go back up the stairs to your office, number 427.
Mm-hmm.
And on the screen, you see
you see a message, and it says, "Welcome, Stanley, to your first day of work. Push start to continue."
Yes! Button pushing! I'm gonna push start.
I push escape.
Fight me!
Push escape. Roll to push escape.
Both okay, I can roll. I can break the rules.
Push buttons.
Oh, break no! the rules?
You can break the rules.
Get three ones.
You know, I have level 4 in that.
Oh, well.
Wait, no, I only have level 3 in that, you're right.
Haha, 3 1s, let's go!
Break rules, yeah. Okay. Well, actually, could that count as breaking the rules of the game?
Yes.
Cool.
No! Level 4.
So you press escape, and you don't black out, but you suddenly lose control of your body as your consciousness, all four of you, drift away and slightly backwards. You see yourself sitting at your own desk, and you see a list of options as if you have just accessed a pause menu.
At this moment, can I press load and then load the Valhalla save?
You never went into the portal to Valhalla. You simply opened
it. No, we were outside of it. That's what I mean. Can we go back to that point by going to the load menu?
You can try.
We're in a goddamn menu in a D&D game. Or roll for shoes.
Can I click the exit button? Exit game button.
I wanna try and access the menu. The console, yeah.
Yeah.
And enter a cheat code.
Okay. You begin loading up the save where you had just finished making the portal to Valhalla.
Don't let it be corrupted.
And you open up the console, which pauses the loading process in the background. You see all of the various weird processes that have been going on in the background. Stuff like echo location, words, meanings that you have no idea what they reference or what they even could have been used for. What do you do in the console?
He entered a cheat code.
I enter a cheat code. I don't know what the cheat code does, but I enter it.
All right, you enter a cheat code.
Hacker man.
Hey, we can get that achievement that you could only unlock by cheating and staying terrible.
Serious room. Well, it didn't work.
I need to... 1 minute.
Are you looking up what happens in the Stanley Parable when you try to cheat?
Since he actually interrupted the loading process, can I try it again?
No, you're in the serious room now.
Oh. Can I load from the serious room?
Stop!
Load from the serious room. You're back in the serious room.
What's the serious room? Wait.
I'm looking this up, goddammit.
We're just playing the Stanley Parable now.
But Valhalla, and it's drifting.
Okay.
Okay. Is that all it is? I think I heard someone clearing their throat.
I'm trying to find my notes, goddammit.
I'm sorry, sir. Mr. Narrator, Mr. Voice in my head. There seems like there's so many of us up in here these days.
All right, I'm somehow having a very hard time finding this, so I'm just gonna bring it. Stanley.
Yes. Hi, I'm Stanley. You
have just made a serious mistake, Stanley. Which is why I brought you here to the serious room. This is the room where I go to be serious. Everything in this room is serious. The walls, even the table, is serious. I looked at hundreds, thousands of tables, and of them, this was the most serious.
I break the table.
Roll to break the table.
At the same time, making fart noises.
Roll to make fart noises.
Yes.
Wait, I could roll to make fart noises, because that'll actually happen, because I have the restroom.
Oh, that's a I level up in why so serious.
You level up in breaking tables. You fart. Stanley, I'm curious. You have just attempted to cheat using console commands. This runs the risk of ruining the entire experience and breaking or corrupting the game.
Can I flip them off?
You can attempt to flip him off, but he is a disembodied voice. You have no idea where it
is. I'm going to flip off the ceiling. I'm going to flip off. Yeah, do I have to roll for that?
Yes.
You do not. All right.
Can I level that up to rudeness?
Sure.
As he's failing at figuring out, remembering what finger to use to flip off the ceiling.
You look around for the door, but you don't find a door.
That's not what I'm trying to do.
Pablo.
Oh. I was gonna do something. Fuck, what was it? I say, what do you mean use console commands? We're playing a role-playing game right now. I'm literally doing nothing with the keyboard other than rolling dice. This is a different... There are no console commands in this game because it is physical.
Roll persuasion.
What about breaking the rules of the game?
Rules of the game.
Steve, why are you talking like you're someone other than you?
How long is that one?
Oh my god. This is great.
No!
I'm being serious, Stanley. Bitch, get the fuck out. You're not going to take this game seriously, as I do. You need to leave.
Can I revert to any save right now so he forgets?
You try to reach your save file. Nothing happens.
I didn't even get a roll.
Again to reach your save file. Actually, fuck it, roll.
I didn't even get a roll. What kind of bullshit is this?
But nobody cares.
I don't even have to.
You rolled a 69.
I don't even have to right now. It's going to be not good.
Pablo rolled.
Why is that a level 20, though?
Please. Voice. Inside. Okay, so that didn't work. You said you wanted us to leave, Mr. Disembodied Voice. Steve.
You see a door in the wall just sort of from behind you, and there's a doorway into a very dark, dark hallway that seems to be leading to a sort of mechanical back room sort of area.
Okay.
To it.
You take a step into the hallway and proceed, and through the dim orange and red light, you manage to make your way through a series of twists and turns through what you can only describe as a maintenance tunnel somewhere. And you find yourself in a much more brightly lit room comparatively. There's still only a single light bulb hanging from the ceiling on about a yard-long string or wire cord, and it casts light down onto a table. Behind the table, you can see there is a vaguely cubic shape, a seemingly metallic cube of sorts.
Okay.
And on the table is a button, a big red button.
All right, I pull the button.
Additionally, off to your left, also hanging from the ceiling, you see what appears to be a long length of rope tied into a noose.
I pull the button.
Can I unplug the computer? I feel like we need to do the nuclear option.
I pull the button.
Roll to pull the button.
Okay.
So you firmly grasp the edges of the button and pull upwards, revealing a small cavity inside the button with another yet smaller button. This one is green.
I pull the button.
This button is flush into the ground of whatever cavity it is in. You cannot get a grip on it to pull it. You would have to push it.
Luckily, I can break physics. I push my fingers through and pull the button out. No!
Can I pull the cable? Can I pull the plug out of the computer because we need to do a nuclear option?
This isn't a computer, it's just a button.
Well, no, I mean, like, we're playing a game, though, right?
Oh, God!
We're playing the game, right? I'm gonna pull the plug on the computer we're playing the game on, and then
okay.
Put it back in.
Roll to...
You roll can't to break the rules of the game.
Break the game.
What?
Roll to be speedy.
Roll to be speedy.
He has the same skills as speedy, right? Because it's the same person.
No.
Yeah.
No, our skills are separate. Your different personalities.
So that's I'm rolling to be speedy, right?
Pretty hey, much. Wait, speedy used my super speed earlier to navigate. So wouldn't that mean we're just no, right back there and we were just really confused, right?
What did he do?
I didn't do that. I broke physics to go really fast.
Aww.
Oh. Well, there goes all five of my levels that I built up to get super speed then. One physics breaking thing.
I mean, it took me 3. I'm at, like, break physics is level 4, so. Mm-hmm. Alright, so Ben did not succeed in being me, probably, right?
No, come on. You didn't even roll yet.
Yeah, you have to roll speed.
Oh, I have to roll?
Yeah, because you're trying not to not be you.
Can I break the game for that?
I mean, sure, go ahead.
No.
At the very least.
All right, then it is literally impossible for Ben to win this.
It is. I like to level that up.
Okay. Be me.
I like to level that up to being possession.
Okay.
Possession.
You are in a small room surrounded by darkness and maintenance, like shelves of unknown tools and stuff. In front of you is a wooden table with a button on top, which has been pulled upwards to reveal yet another smaller button underneath it.
I want to push the button.
I want to criticize the art in the room and determine how well decorated this room is.
I vote for pushing the button.
Okay. Looking around the room, you notice that there isn't actually any art, so in that book it is pretty barren in your respect.
Abstract.
Just how well designed the room is.
The most artistic thing you do notice in the room, though, is on the cube, every single face of the cube has a pink heart.
Did we get into a different game?
I didn't change the game. I mean, it's same source engine.
There is what looks like a companion cube next to a table, on top of which is a red button, which has been pulled up to reveal a smaller green button, which is flush with the table. Further off to your left, there is a noose hanging from the ceiling. Also hanging from the ceiling is a single light bulb on a cord illuminating all of this.
Hold on. I have killing myself as a level 3 skill.
No! No! God damn it.
What's he gonna do?
Suicide is a level 3 skill for me.
You have level 3 suicide? What's...
No!
I got drowning for level 2, and then I put, like, killing
but
myself...
But I thought I already purged. I thought I already purged them.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So...
suicidal thoughts.
Done. Do away.
Quiet. What? You're peeking. It's
how am I peeking? I'm just speaking. I can't speak anymore. Okay, I'm going to shut up now. I'm going to shut up forever.
You just gotta
shut up forever.
Just gotta
shut up.
Use a smaller voice.
I rolled a lot of sixes earlier when I was trying to fail things for experience.
All right, so you tried to kill yourself. Is that what's happening?
Yeah.
Steve, you want to roll
against Ben's not dying?
Oh yeah,
pacifism.
Ben's pacifism.
Pacifism.
Yeah.
But I thought I already purged his thoughts. Oh wait, now I'm.
Maybe it was just for that one attempt, you know.
No.
I rolled two ones. You should be able to beat this.
Are you come along, Ben.
What? I'm trying to think. Oh, wait, no, I should speak. Okay.
Pablo, why do you keep trying to kill us?
I want to see what happens. Does it end the session? Do we get transported to Valhalla?
So you look at the news and you step up on the table to get a better reach at it, wrap it around your head, and hang yourself.
Can I revert? Okay. Can I revert to any save? Please, I've been trying to do that. Can I revert?
He turned off cheats.
No. Load. It's not a cheat. Loading the game is not a cheat.
We were punished for trying to cheat in the first place.
Well, that's his fault. That shouldn't be my fault.
We're all the same person.
Can I load?
And I just killed.
Damn it, Steven, can I load?
Steven's not here.
It's 10:40 and I'm trying to find a way to end this.
Can I load?
Got him.
I did it. Did I do it, Steve? We're dead?
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley had a troubled life, with not one but four voices in his head conflicting, telling him what to do. He was friends with another person from across the world even, by the name of Red, but his problem was not nearly as severe as Red's. Nevertheless, Stanley found it very hard to do even the most simple of tasks, and eventually, on one strange day, which turned into a very strange series of days, which led to his untimely death, Stanley was completely and utterly alone.
This got really sad.
Did he at least drift into Valhalla?
Fuck it, yes you did.
game changer Brawlhalla.
Oh my god, just end the stream.
Where you fight for eternity. We did it!
Yeah, we did it.
We died. Good work, team!
But all my...
Live eternally.
Wait, can we keep our stuff for another... Can we keep our stuff? Because I'm very attached.
I'm not following this up.
I'm very attached, please.
I am not following this up with another...
No.
Choose some other time, but it will not be this.
Oh,
can
God.
I wait? Can I roll to save this? Can I roll to save this? That's level
no.
Level 4. It's level 5 actually. Please.
Here, I'll roll out to save it. Don't worry, Steve.
Okay. Can I roll to save this? Aww.
God damn it.
That's so sad.
Alright. We will play Roll for Shoes some other time because this is really fun. But we will change the plot to be not Stanley Parable. Maybe with different characters.
Oh man.
Oh my god. Remember that time we were in Hartlepool Boyfriend together as Stanley?
I tried that to have babies.
That was an experience.
Remember that time that I made a rule that I could break the rules?
And I immediately said I should not have given you this power.
Man, why can we get into space? I mean, if you only did. That door hadn't fallen off.
Hey, Tomato Pro. We're actually going to end soon. Oh my god, that was fantastic. That was brilliant. We're great. All right.
Good stuff.
Let's go through and do shoutouts or whatever. Steve.
Yo, I'm Steve. I GM every week.
Yeah. This is the time that we usually do for our long-running series Dungeon Runners. But we were missing a player today, and so we decided to try something different with Roll for Shoes. And my god. Things got out of hand.
Very.
Out of foot. Out of rules, out of the game.
Out of logic.
At one point, I paused the game. I entered a pause menu in an RPG.
A tabletop RPG.
But I digress. My name is Speedy, this is my channel, and we play D&D on this channel every week. You can also see me playing D&D on the channel Exploding Dice on Saturdays at 9. Or you can see me here playing any other game on normal weekdays, because I do that. Not enough cowbell. Yeah. And so, Ben.
Yes.
Say who you are and where people find you.
I'm Ben. I stream sometimes. You can find me most anywhere as Ben_is_able. I might stream soon. You gotta watch for that. It's usually I had a schedule, but that's really up there. I'm sorry, but yeah, I'm apparently pretty awesome. I guess.
He's pretty cool. A pretty cool dude.
But apparently too loud.
Yeah, when you said that, you were very loud, yes.
Really? I made sure not to be as loud. No.
That's okay. All right, Pablo.
I'm Pablo. The stream hasn't been working for a little bit. I got it back working. I'm going to start streaming again.
Where can they find you?
Twitch.tv/Poblondo is... Yeah, that one. Thank you, Speedy. Caster Poblondo, that's me. Yeah. I'm going to start playing just a million Nintendo games, by the way.
Nice.
I'm going to get Mega Man.
and then there's Spivey. He doesn't...
Yeah.
You know, he's last streamed some World of Warcraft. How long ago was that?
Wow. I didn't even stream it. It was on for like 10 minutes to see if my internet could do it. That was it.
So, could your internet do it?
Going strong. Yeah, no, it can. It can.
Fascinating.
Maybe one day. Nah, but I just fucking play games and stuff.
Yeah.
On the Discord.
Yeah. All these guys are here every week playing this game at this time. Not this game. D&D at this time. And we'll play various games with me at other times.
By the one dragon.
You can also find them on Discord where their names are the same thing. Or actually, Steve's is the other guy. But other than that, check out the Discord.
Right, oh, never mind.
But yeah, that's where you can catch us all. This has been Roll for Shoes, apparently. Jesus Christ. thank you guys so much for coming out here and watching. This has been super fun. And I will see you next time. And as always, don't forget to take it slow. Bye.